Hello, everybody, and welcome to... actually, I should probably refresh this because the video is not working yet. Okay, and let's go ahead and I want to... Oh, you can't pause it, right? Okay, we got a bit of a dev blog here to make. I know I haven't covered War Thunder stuff for quite a while, and when I was covering it, I wasn't covering it that often. But I got told today, or earlier today, that there was supposed to be a dev blog, or most likely a dev blog coming today, and... Here it is at 7:11, or about. It came out a few minutes ago, but I was in a Discord. I was in the Discord server with some people, so I was just kind of talking rather than making the video. But it's quite pig news. It's quite big news. Okay, no, it's fucking massive news that caught me way the fuck off guard. First, it was like Challenger 2, and I'm like, well, there's a Challenger 2 driving outside your window or something. No, it's a Challenger 2 in War Thunder. I was like, okay. I guess they're really taking the big steps up here with rank 6. But then it says rank 7 armored vehicles. Rank 7 already? I mean, I thought that was... I mean, now this isn't a complaint. Don't get me wrong by this. This isn't a rant or a complaint or anything. I'm totally okay with it. I'm just saying I thought that was the point of rank 6. To be the modern stuff up into present day at some point. I didn't know they were going to go and drop another rank. So somebody on Discord, I don't know if it was an actual concern that they have or not, but they just said kind of jokingly, you know, so what does this mean? That there'll be rank 6 premiums of like $80 prices tags now? Honestly, I'm kind of have that as a genuine question. Because for the first time, we got rank 5 premiums when they started releasing rank 6 content. And they are very, very expensive. And now all of a sudden, we've got rank 7? Are they going to start adding rank 6 premiums now? I just kind of feel like it defeats the whole purpose of what they've been following, but, I mean, the content at least is going to be pretty fucking badass, this modern stuff that we're getting. I mean, we're working, you know, this is, we're, rank 7, I guess, is going to be the modern shit, like the modern shit. I don't know, whatever. Maybe it'll say somewhere in the dev blog, I haven't read it yet, but I am going to play this with audio because everybody in the Discord chat said something about the music being really fucking weird, so I want to listen to it. But keep in mind, you might want to turn your volume down because this is usually really fucking loud. So there's your warning. Quickly turn it down. Here we go. Okay, I fucking see what the fuck they're talking about. That fucking music, I can't take the tank seriously with that fucking music playing over top of it. I mean, I know they've done this music shit for a long time, but usually it's like some metal stuff or, you know, or some heavy rock sometimes. Sometimes they do some of that technical or like that techno shit, but I don't know. This just doesn't seem like it fits the tank, honestly. Whatever. Anyways, let's go ahead and see what they've got going here. Challenger 2 and Rank 7 Armored Vehiculars. The highly anticipated update 1.87, which will bring War Thunder even closer to modern warfare, is just around the corner. You will see a new rank, Rank 7, armored vehicles, and many other novelties. What? Novelties for aircraft and fleets. Be sure to follow the news. Rank 7 armored vehicles. Update 1.87 will introduce even more armored vehicles that were created and in service during the 80s and 90s of the 20th century, and well known for participating in armed conflicts of that period. Okay, hold on. I completely blacked out while I read that, so I didn't even contemplate what the fuck I just said, so hold on a minute. Update 1.87 will introduce even more armored vehicles that were created in and in service during the 80s and 90s. 20th century. That's great. I mean, I'm honestly kind of excited now to see more modern stuff. Can we have some World War II content? You know, I mean, I know we've been getting it here and there, but there's still some items that I would really like to see and that I know a lot of other people would really like to see. The modern stuff's cool and it kind of needs to be fleshed out, I think, in terms of content. But still, though, you know, I mean, just asking. It's just, you know, just asking. Soon, we are going to give a detailed account of this tech in our developer diary, so stay tuned. Since many of the tanks in our game also belong to the third generation MBT in terms of their technical specifications and combat effectiveness, we will continue some changes to the battle ratings and rank positioning of some tanks in the rank 5 and 6 ranks to better balance the land and combined battles in War Thunder. So I guess that means some vehicles might be going up or down in battle ratings. So I'm hoping that this means that the battle ratings are going to forever increase from whatever the max is now, 10.0 or whatever it is. I don't remember what the max ground battle rating is. I think that'll be nice, but we'll just have to wait and see. I don't know. I'm trying to be, you know, you should be able to tell that I'm not like just straight up dissing everything right now and what they're doing. I'm trying to see the improvements and stuff that can be made here. You know, even if you want to say that Gaijin doesn't give a shit, you know, I still have a little bit of hope. You know, that they'll do something good here. Developed in the mid-80s as a successor to the Challenger 1, the Challenger 2 shows that Britain knew how to count. Entered service in the early 90s and continues to serve with the British Army today, as it should. It's a fantastic-looking tank. In the upcoming update 1.87, War Thunder tankers may look forward to the opportunity of commanding the most modern MBT fielded by the British Army. Briefly, the successor to the Challenger 1 and the most advanced MBT presently in service with the British Armed Forces. There's some history on the vehicle if you give a shit. And of course, we get to see some screenshots of it with all the various different camouflages. There's the very beautiful green and black camo that I really like. And we've got an interesting one here. It's kind of like a light greenish gray almost, striped over some tan. It's not bad looking, honestly. And then, of course, you've got the shit brown that I don't like at all, but that's just me. Anyways, in War Thunder, the Challenger 2 will be a new addition to the top ranks of the British Ground Forces tree, and among the first vehicles to be added to the game as part of the new rank 7 for Ground Forces. Are we going to talk about the rank 7? Because I would like to get an explanation on that at the very least. Being introduced with update 1.87. Being built on the basis of the Challenger 1 and Challenger 2 features many similarities with its predecessor, but introduces several improvements at the same time as well, allowing British tankers to transition from one vehicle to the other almost seamlessly. Although the Challenger 2 is fitted with a new L30A1 cannon, compared to the L11 found on previous machines, the cannon is still a rifled one, as British doctrine continued to emphasize the importance of the ability to fire Hesh rounds. As a result, the L30 cannon shares a good deal of its ballistics properties with its L11 predecessor, with the exception that it's able to fire newer and better performing subcaliber rounds. Firepower is not where the similarities between the two Challengers end, though, as mobility is very comparable between the two vehicles as well. The Challenger 2 retains a 1200 horsepower V12 diesel engine, although the exact model differs from the Challenger 1. As both vehicles have closely matched weight, it comes to no surprise that the Challenger 2 matches its predecessor in mobility, being able to reach a maximum speed of 35 miles per hour, 56 kilometers an hour, under ideal conditions. The major difference between the two vehicles, however, is armor protection. Although the general layout remains similar, the emphasis is still being put on extremely thick frontal turret armor. The Challenger 2 is fitted with not just more, but also a newer type of armor, providing the vehicle with more than 500 millimeters of protection against kinetic and over 900 millimeters against heat rounds. Good lord. However, the hull of the Challenger 2 not only retains a similar protection level as that of the Challenger 1, but also inherits some of the major weak spots, such as the thinly armored lower glacis plate. Look there, they use the glacis word again that Google seems to say isn't a real word, but... And, you know, I've used it for how many years now, and then people got really angry, and I stopped using it. And then when I said I stopped using it, people got angry about it and said that it is a word. And I was like, okay, I know, but I was using it before, but okay. Anyways, look at this tank. This tank looks fucking beautiful from the side like this. Good lord. Looks all right from the front, but this side shot is glorious. Overall, the Challenger 2 will provide British tankers with a new but familiar feeling MBT, which features some crucial improvements in firepower and protection in particulate. However, as the vehicle retains identical mobility and its predecessor and inherits its general armor layout and design philosophy, the Challenger 2 will remain a second-line support tank rather than a front-line brawler. The Challenger 2 will charge into War Thunder ground battles with the upcoming release of Update 1.87. In the meantime, be sure to stay tuned to the news for the latest developments on the next major update and all that bullshit. Who gives a shit? Rank 7, guys. Challenger 2, guys. What the fuck is going on? I don't know. No explanation. At least as far as I can tell, there's no explanation here. Oh, by the way, Valentine's Day was like yesterday. I don't, you know, if you wanted to see that event, I didn't make a video on it. I guess I'm doing a really bad job, I can tell. But Challenger 2 and Rank 7, let me know in the comments below what you think. Hopefully we get a dev blog on Rank 7, because I kind of want a detailed explanation as to why they decided to make Rank 7, you know, and split that up. Because, I mean, you know, if it's just so that they can release a shitload of really expensive rank 6 premiums, I'm not really going to be too happy about that. I'm all okay for these premium vehicles and stuff, but it's just the $60 packs are kind of getting a little out of hand. And now if we're possibly going to get even more expensive packs, you know, it's you're pushing it. I mean, I haven't been able to buy shit for War Thunder recently because it's just getting too expensive. Anyways, guys, let me know in the comments below what you think about this, and I will see you in the next War Thunder video.